Cramer's rule. Solution of system of linear equation. Cramer's rule or determined method. Let us consider the equation with the variable x, y, z. We will find the delta value. How to find the delta value? We will write the coefficient of x, coefficient of y, and coefficient of z. We know how to expand this determinant. Then we can find the delta. Delta 1 or delta x equal to, replace x by the constant, that is d1, d2, d3. Expand it, we can find the delta 1. Delta 2, instead of coefficient of y, replace the constant, delta d1, d2 and d3. Delta 3 is nothing but, replace the z coefficient by d1, d2, d3. So by Cramer's rule, we get x equal to delta 1 by delta, y equal to delta 2 by delta, z equal to delta 3 by delta. In this, delta is not equal to 0, so that we can find x, y, z. If it is of 2 by 2, only 2 variable x and y is given, we can use the same condition x and y, delta 1 and delta 2, we can find x and y. X is 1.5, solve the following by Cramer's rule. 2x plus 3y equal to 11, x minus y minus 3 equal to 0. Solution, write the given equation. Now find the delta value. To find delta value, we are trying the coefficient of x and coefficient of y. Now we have to expand this. Multiply 2 into minus 1 minus 1 into 3. We get minus 2 minus 3. So delta value is minus 5. Now we will find delta 1. Replace the coefficient of x by 11 and 3. We again multiply 11 with minus 1 minus 3 into 3. We get minus 20. Delta 2 equal to, replace the coefficient of y by 11 and 3. Multiply 2 into 3. 1 into 11. We get minus 5. By Cramer's rule, we get x equal to delta 1 by delta. Substitute the values. Delta 1 is minus 20 by minus 5. We get x equal to 4. Y equal to delta 2 by delta. By substituting minus 5 by 5 and cancelling, we get y equal to 1. Second problem, 3x plus 4y equal to 7, 7x equal to y plus 6. Solution, we will write the given equation. Find the determinant equal to, write the coefficient of x and coefficient of y. Now we have to simplify this determinant. 3 into minus 1 minus 7 into 4, we get minus 31. Delta 1, replace coefficient of x by the constant 7 and 6 and multiply 7 with minus 1, 6 with 4, we get minus 31. Delta 2 equal to, replace the coefficient of y by the constant 7 and 6, 3 into 6 minus 7 into 7, we get minus 31. By Cramer's rule, we know that x equal to delta 1 by delta. By simplification, we get x value as 1. Y equal to delta 2 by delta, minus 31 by 31. Equal to 1. So we found x and y. Third problem, 3x plus 2y equal to 8, 4x minus 3y equal to 5. Solution, we will write the given equation. delta equal to, write the coefficient of x and y. Now multiply 3 into minus 3 minus 4 into 2. We get delta as minus 17. Delta 1 equal to, replace the coefficient of x by constant 8 and 5. 8 into minus 3 minus 5 into 2 minus 34. Delta 2 equal to, replace the coefficient of y by the constant 8 and 5, 3 into 5 minus 4 into 8 minus 17. By Cram's rule, x equal to delta 1 by delta minus 34 by minus 17 equal to 2. Y equal to delta 2 by delta, we get 1. Fourth one, solution, we'll write the given equation, delta equal to coefficient of x and coefficient of y, 3 into 2 into minus 3, 1 into 1, we get minus 7. Delta 1 equal to, replace the coefficient of x by constant 1 and 4 and expand this determinant, we get minus 7. Delta 2, replace the coefficient of y by the constant, multiply 2 into 4, 1 into 1, 7. By Cramer's rule, x equal to delta 1 by delta minus 7 by 7 equal to 1. Y equal to delta 2 by delta, we get minus 1. Second question, solved by Cramer's rule, three equations are given, solution, we'll write the given equation, we'll find the delta value, replace the coefficient of x, y and z, we'll expand this determinant by the first row, we'll simplify this, 4 into, next we'll take with the second one, minus 1 into, and then 0 into. The solution is given here. We know to take alternately plus and minus. Therefore, we got the value as 56. Delta 1 equal to, replace the coefficient of x by constant, that is 7, 5 and 2. Now, we'll do the, we'll expand by the row 1. 7 into, now 1 into the matrix equal to 63 minus 7, that is 56. Delta 2 equal to, replace the coefficient of y by the constant 7, 5 and 2 and expand by the first row. We'll take 4, that corresponding row and column, next with 7, next with 0, the expansion is 28 plus 140 equal to 168. Delta 3 equal to, the determinant, by replacing the coefficient of z into constant 752, and expanding by the first row, we have to expand by the first row, so leave out that respective columns, we get minus 56. By Cramer's rule, we get x equal to delta 1 by delta, x value as 1. Y equal to delta 2 by delta, y equal to 3. Z is equal to delta 3 by delta, equal to minus 1. Second problem, the equation is given. Solution, we will write the given equation. Now we'll write the determinant value, write the coefficient of x, y and z, and expand the determinant, we get minus 3. Expansion already we have seen in previous videos, I have explained how to take alternative plus minus by expanding by row wise, column wise, we have seen. Delta 1 equal to, replace the coefficient of x by the constant 7, 17, 37, and expand it, we get minus 6. So the expansion is shown, you can work out and check. Delta 2, replace the coefficient of y by the constant, and then expanding by the first row, we get the determinant value as delta 2 as minus 9. Delta 3, replace the coefficient of z by the constant 7, 17, 37. Expanding by the row, first row, we get delta 3 as minus 6. By Cramer's rule, we get x equal to delta 1 by delta equal to minus 6 by minus 3, x equal to 2. Y equal to delta 2 by delta, that is equal to minus 9 by minus 3. By cancelling, we get y value as 3. Z equal to delta 3 by delta, minus 6 by minus 3, that is equal to 2. Third problem, solution, write on the given equation, delta equal to, substitute the coefficient of x, y and z, expanding by the first row, leave out the first column. Now we know how to multiply, 5 into 2 minus 3 into 3, similarly with the second column. We have to leave the second column and multiply 2 into 2 minus 5 into 3. Similarly, the third column, we get 3 into 10 minus 9 minus 2 into 4 minus 15 plus 5 into 6 minus 25. Alternately, plus minus plus we have to take equal to minus 70. Delta 1 equal to determinant of, replace the coefficient of x by the constant 32, 31, 27 and expand this by the first row. Expansion we have seen in previous video. If you are not seen, see that video so that it will, you can able to understand how to expand this determinant. By expanding, we get the value as minus 140. Delta 1 equal to minus 140. Now we'll find delta 2. Delta 2 means replace the coefficient of y by the constant. Expanding by the first row, leave out the first column, this expansion we have to do, minus 32 into, leave out the second column, expand this, and the third row, third column, we get minus 210. Delta 3 equal to, replace the coefficient of z by the constant. Again, same procedure, you have to expand by the column or row. Here we expanded by the row, so leave out the first column, expand this, minus 2 into this and the third column, we get minus 280. By Cramer's rule, we get x equal to delta 1 by delta, substitute delta 1 value and delta value, minus 140 divided by minus 70 equal to 2. Y equal to delta 2 by delta, minus 210 by minus 70 equal to 3. Z equal to delta 3 by delta, minus 280 by minus 70 equal to 4. So we got X, Y and Z values. Fourth problem, determine, we have to find delta, write the coefficient of X, Y and Z, expanding by the first row, leave out the first column, second and third. By expanding, we get minus 4. Delta 1 equal to, determine, replace the coefficient of X by the constant. Just for you to understand, I have given different color so that you can easily can able to understand. Expanding by the first row, leave out the first column, second column, third column, we get 4. Delta 1 equal to 4. Delta 2 equal to, replace the coefficient of y by the constant. Leave out the first row. Leave out the first column now. Second column and third column. By expanding by the first row, we get delta 2 as 8. Delta 3 equal to, replace the coefficient of z by the constant. By expanding, we get minus 12. Already I clearly explained this, determined how to expand this. If you are not seen the video, see that video how to expand that, and then if you come to this Cramer's rule, it will be easy for you to understand. By Cramer's rule, we get X equal to delta 1 by delta, that is 4 by minus 4, minus 1. Y equal to delta 2 by delta, 8 by minus 4, minus 2. Z equal to delta 3 by delta, therefore we got the value as 3. So by this we are seen 2 by 2 and 3 by 3 by using Cramer's rule. Determined expansion already in my video, if you have seen, you can clearly and you can able to understand how to expand this determined. If you are not seen, see the determined, then come to this video.